I am Paul Goddard, and my role is Stewardship Value Chain Manager at BASF, which covers, in part of it, water stewardship. Bentazone is a challenge for the water companies in particular, because it is found more months of the year, more locations, and at higher levels than any other plant protection product. And that makes a challenge for the water companies, it makes a challenge for the Environment Agency as well. We want to keep the chemistry, and we want to make sure that people are using the chemistry in a way, there's certain steps that we can take to help in that, to manage the situation. One of these we're going to talk about today is point sources, and one of the real advantages of working with point sources is they can be avoided. The other form of contamination is diffuse sources. They can be managed in the field. In terms of the we, it is the whole of the agriculture, and I'd say environment and water company landscape. I see this as being like a partnership, all of us working together for the same goal or goals. We don't want the chemistry to be found in our water. It's a waste if it's in the water. It's not doing what you want it to do if it's there. But also it's a cost to have it removed. And it's a challenge in terms of the legislation we have in place. So it is growers that use the product. It's us as manufacturers, and not just BASF, but also Nufarm and Sharda that have a product in the marketplace. It's water companies as well that have a cost with regards to removing the water. Ultimately, we all benefit because we all drink that water as well. And there's not many people that do not have a water bill that comes through. So we have that cost associated with us as individuals. The real challenge is that if we can't manage the bentazone being found, or if we can't show that we are moving towards a management of the active being found in water, then the challenge going forward will be, when we come to the reapproval, which is in 2025, there will be another pressure put upon it not being reapproved. That will be a particular challenge for pulse growers, but we know it's used in other crops as well, with emus, it's used in potatoes too. But I think the real challenge is for pulses in particular. We live in a world now where there's fewer and fewer options chemistry-wise. Bentazone is one of those post-em options that we have for legumes. I think it'd be fair to say that growers use it because they have very little other options available to them. So without that option, what do they do? That would be the question. We need to, as an industry, you know, as the growers, water companies, as us as manufacturers, to manage the situation, which we can with stewardship, to stop the challenge that we have going forward with it being found in water. In terms of optimum timing, we need to look at the weeds and the growth stage of those weeds and the crop as well. But in terms of the application itself, what we need to think about is the conditions that are happening around the application. In terms of surface water, we don't want it moving away from the field. That can be in the form of drift. It can be in the form of runoff. So bear in mind what rain is coming. Also bear in mind the water courses around and about the fields. It is advised to have no spray zones or buffer zones around fields against water courses. Once it's below the surface, it is slow to break down. It breaks down quickly at the surface. If we keep it there, so much the better.